What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Jager2K. Hey, man, today we're going to beat on the same drum that we've beat on a couple of times in the past, and that's the physical handle badge paired with the bulldozer badge, bro. So pretty much we're going to talk about contact dribbling once again, a subject that 2K did a horrible job promoting in their 2K24 trailer. So NBA 2K24 Next Gen, right? It gives us the ability to dribble through contact, play through contact, do shot creation through contact, do advanced shots, dribble moves, advanced layups, whatever you want through contacts, bro. So when they said strength was gonna matter this 2K, they really meant it. So strength is very viable in this game. Typically in 2Ks of the past, the goal of a dribbler or a ball handler was to avoid contact and create as much space as possible. But this 2K has enabled us to play through contact, to actually seek out and invite contact and play through said contact. It is a completely viable play style, as y'all are going to be seeing in these clips that I'm putting in this video. Literally playing through the contact is very viable. It is also a way to beat CPUs, to beat them strong ass defenders that be locking y'all down, right? It's a way to just to score, bro. It's a way, you know how you need that angle to get the dunk meter, the big dunk meter, like I showed in my dunk meter tutorial. This is also a way to do that, because there are so many variations, right? You can spin off, you can do a spin off of a contact, you can do an offhand push off through contact, you can do a behind the back through contact, you can do a between the legs through contact, you can do a move where he does a double behind the back through contact, right? And there's this weird spin move that you can also get through contact. So it's just what you do at that point of contact, right? You have to read that situation. And also, 2K isn't just going to bail you out and then automatically put you in a winning animation after you do that move. You have to do something else after that, whether that is doing a pull-up or doing a scoop layup after that, or doing a Euro or passing the ball, or just you have to mix that with something else. You can't just do it in a nutshell and then expect to be open. You do it to throw your defender off, and then you have to finish that move. All right, so don't expect it to be easy to where you can just spam it. Well, actually, in park, if you know what you're doing, you can literally get a nutmeg every single time down the court. If your defender is not stronger than you, or they don't know how to stop it, you can literally just throw the ball between their legs, and if they don't have block, they are fucked. But if they have block, they can actually still get kind of a contest. But if you do that and with a dunk rating, and you do it for the dunk meter, oh my god, I can only imagine what that looks like. So yeah, dribbling through contact is completely viable, bro. And hey, I ain't gonna lie, y'all need to follow me on Twitter, because I'll be voicing these things on Twitter, and obviously I don't have an audience out there to listen, but I really want to promote this playstyle because I think it's very viable, and this is doing 2K24 an injustice to how underutilized it is. The only thing I'd love to figure out, and I don't know if 2K Labs will ever look into this one day, because I don't think they're even interested in this aspect of the game, but I would love to see what level of strength brings the most inconsistency, right? So you can get Hall of Fame physical contact at an 84 strength with the right ball handle, of course. So I'm wondering if that 84 strength would go pair well against a immovable enforcer gold that you get at like a 90 strength, right? So I would love to know the difference between that, because I would love to make an optimized build, because this build that I use has a 92 and I pretty much get it fairly consistently. I haven't taken him in Pro-Am. I need to do that so I can see what it's talking about against those OD ass locks. Whenever I get the chance, I'll let y'all know how that goes. But, well, actually, it pairs with Bulldozer, so your Bulldozer will only be a silver, so that would take away a little bit. But yeah, physical contact and Bulldozer together, man, oh my god. You're like, if a build with no strength tries to check you, bro, you literally just blow by them. Like, you just ease them off like they're not even there, like they're Casper or Ghost. It's crazy. And I just think I would love for 2K Lab to do some more testing on that, just so we can get more clarity on this difference in strength that you get the most effectiveness out of. Because some people, I feel like I can get animations on I can get animations at will, and then others I feel like I have to try a little bit harder, get them leaning a little bit more. So I'm guessing that's the difference, but man, trust me, bro. You can definitely make a strong ass build that can just go to work. Trust me. And it would be a completely viable playstyle. The only thing I would say is it pairs very well with post control too. So this build, I got 92 post control and 92 strength. And trust me, man, I feel like I can score in a variety of ways. And actually, I feel like I can score in any way I want to. Right? So yeah, it's crazy just how diverse this game is, but we're still forcing each other to play the same way. And I don't think we have to. Because even with my build, right? The other day I was playing fives and they were hiding their point guard in the left corner of the zone, right? And what I did was I posted that point guard. Like, I kicked the ball up to the top, posted a PG, and just kept going to work on him. So they had to like adjust their defense that he couldn't hide him in the corner, because I'm literally going over to that side and posting him, and you can't stop me because I got 92 midi, 92 post fade. And then this build that I got to is so much fun in 5v5. So if you play like starting five or whatever with this build, man, it is so fun. And I see so many builds go in there and they get just completely abused because they have no strength, right? They also, strength helps with defense. So strength matters, bro. But 2K did a terrible job flushing it out. And it is so sad, bro. It's so sad because you can really play like SGA. On this build, I feel like I play like SGA, literally. Literally, because I'm doing, bro, there is like, even when you're getting full court pressed, you can move people out of the way, bro. Like, it is actually ridiculous. If you, as soon as that contact initiates and you do like a behind the back, which is one of the best moves out of that physical contact animation, you're getting them out of there, trust me. And then you can do the you can get the physical contact animation and then go straight into a post fade after it, bro. It's just not post fade. You can go straight into like a regular fade, but you just gotta navigate your player well, bro. Yeah, y'all see the clips, bro. Y'all see what I'm talking about. But like, point is, bro, physical contact and bulldozer is worth putting on a build and trying it, bro. And I'd highly doubt I'm the only person that's ever figured that out. So if y'all play like that, bro, let me know, bro. Like, add me on Twitter, follow me on Twitter, X, whatever. And send me some clips, at me, whatever, bro. But let's get some discourse going, bro, and bring some eyes to this. I really would love to see more of this type of playstyle. Like, seriously, bro, it is crazy. But anyways, man, it's been your boy, Jago2K. Much love, man. We back on the grind. And be sure to hit that like and subscribe button, especially that subscribe button, man. A lot of y'all watching these videos are not subscribed. And yeah, man, follow me on Twitter so we can chat it up. And yeah, man, it's me, your boy, Jago2K, and we out. Peace.